Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the zinc oxide eugenol impression paste. Zinc oxide eugenol is an impression material used for dentures on edentulous ridges with minor or no undercut. It can be classified as rigid, inelastic, irreversible impression material that sets by chemical reaction. It is used for secondary impressions in cases of edentulous patients, for bite registration, as a temporary relining material for dentures, surgical pack in periodontal surgical procedures, for relining or rebasing impressions, for spotting out denture sore spot, and for impressions when loose tissues present over edentulous ridges like flabby tissues. So on the basis of consistency and hardness, it can be classified as type 1 or hard material and type 2 or soft material. The impression material is dispensed as two separate pastes. Tube number 1 is base paste, which contains zinc oxide and fixed vegetable or mineral oil, while tube number 2 is catalyst, which contains oil of cloves or eugenol, gum or polymerized rosin, filler, lanolin, resinous balsam, and accelerators or color and moisture. Coming to the function of each ingredient, the zinc oxide is the reactive ingredient which takes part in the setting reaction. It should be finely divided and it should contain a very slight amount of water. The zinc oxide base component is mixed with inert oils to form a paste. Olive oil or linseed oil can be used. It acts as a plasticizer and also aids in masking the action of eugenol as an irritant. Oil of cloves contains 70-85% eugenol. It is sometimes used in preference to eugenol because it reduces the burning sensation in the soft tissues. The gum rosin gives body and coherence to the mixed material and imparts the thermoplastic properties to the set impression so that it can be softened in hot water for easy removal from the cast. Carnauba wax or cowrie gum can be substituted for gum rosin. Rosin facilitates the speed of the reaction and a smoother, more homogeneous product results. It is an inert material used with eugenol to form a paste of suitable consistency. The resinous balsam is used to increase the flow and improve the mixing properties. Magnesium chloride or calcium chloride can be used as an accelerator. Certain soluble salts and zinc salts such as zinc acetate also act as accelerator. Metallic salts of hydrochloric and nitric acids, primary alcohols and glacial acetic acids are the other accelerators used, and addition of water also increases the setting reaction. The setting reaction is an acid-based reaction to form the chelate. This reaction is known as chelation and product is zinc eugenolate. The setting reaction is ionic in nature. So first, zinc oxide reacts with water to form zinc hydroxide, then zinc hydroxide reacts with eugenol to form zinc eugenolate and water. 5-8% water is essential to initiate the setting reaction. It is supplied in paste form in two tubes. The base paste is white in color and accelerator or catalyst paste is red in color. It is mixed on mixing pads with a stainless steel spatula. Equal lengths of base and catalyst are dispensed on pad and mixed with a spatula. It is mixed with broad strokes and sweeping motion, and after mixing there should be no streak of base or catalyst paste. Then the mix is spread over dry bearing surface of the tray. Under oral conditions the material will usually set within 3 to 5 minutes. After removal, it is rinsed thoroughly under cold running water, and then it can be separated from cast by immersing in hot water at 49 to 60 degrees centigrade for 5 to 10 minutes. Coming to the properties, the initial setting time for type 1 is 3 to 6 minutes, while the final setting time is 10 minutes. For type 2, the initial setting time is 3 to 6 minutes and final setting time is 15 minutes. The initial setting time is from the beginning of the mixing until the material ceases to pull away or string out when its surface is touched with a metal rod. And the final setting time is when a needle of a specified dimension fails to penetrate the surface of the specimen more than 0.2 mm under a load of 50 grams. The setting time can be reduce in the presence of heat and humidity. So it is less in summers and the setting time is more in during winters. Then by the addition of accelerators and by prolonging the mixing time, it is increased by cooling the spatula and glass slab below the dew point. This is the most recommended method of increasing the setting time. And then by mixing of inert oil and waxes and by reducing the quantity of accelerator. The consistency and flow of the freshly mixed paste when it is impressed against the tissues are of considerable clinical importance. A paste of thick consistency or high viscosity can compress the tissues, whereas a thin fluid material results in an impression that copies the tissues in a relaxed condition with little or no compression. The thickness of the paste used is normally around 1 mm. The major restriction on the use of these materials is their lack of elasticity. The said material may distort or fracture when removed over undercuts. The materials are sometimes used to record small undercuts in soft tissues, but the tendency of some paste to flow under relatively small pressures should be remembered. Strength is not a critical requirement for this impression material since it is supported by a tray and is not used in areas where it would be required to withstand extensive deformation and stress during removal from the mouth. The hardness of the set material varies with different products. It is measured by noting the extent to which a loaded needle will penetrate a small specimen of the set material. It is expressed in terms of millimeters penetrated in a given time. The hardness values for Jadoi paste may vary from 0.2 to 2.5 mm. The dimensional stability of most of the impression paste is quite satisfactory. It shrinks in the order of 0.1% or less at the end of 30 minutes after mixing. No significant further change occurs at the end of 24 hours, and these materials can be considered to be reasonably stable in dimension. The relatively low initial viscosity of the mixed paste, coupled with its pseudoplastic nature, allows fine details to be recorded in the impression. The advantages include that the impression is highly accurate, it provides good surface details, it is well adhered to the impression compound, the material is inexpensive, it does not require any separating media, and it is dimensionally stable. While the disadvantages include that the material is messy to work with, the setting time is variable, eugenol is irritating to soft tissues, it is non-elastic in nature, so it is unable to record the undercuts, it requires special trays, and it is sticky in nature and adheres to the tissues. It can be disinfected by immersing in 2% alkaline glutaldehyde solution at room temperature, but not compatible with chlorine compound. Coming to the non-eugenol paste, occasionally eugenol may promote an allergic response in some patients. There may be a stinging or burning sensation when eugenol contacts the soft tissues. Alternative non-eugenol materials are based upon the reaction between zinc oxide and the carboxylic acid such as orthoethoxybenzoic acid to form an insoluble soap. The carboxylic acid may be present as a liquid or as a powder dispersed in a medium such as ethyl alcohol. The reaction is not greatly affected by the temperature or humidity. Thank you. अगर आपको हमारा ये वीडियो अच्छा लगा हो तो इसे प्लीज़ शेयर करें अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ और हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें. Thank you.